Hello everyone, my name is Lixun Peng from MariaDB Foundation. I'm living in China. Today I want to introduce a user case. A China company migrate one of their applications from Oracle to MariaDB. We just done the modified MariaDB version for this user last week. The application is testing in this modified MariaDB version without any application modification. This is my agenda. The first I want to introduce the background. Why the user wants to move to MariaDB, and then I will introduce how we got it step by step. The first is about the user requirements. This user case is driven by Hangzhou Watch Tech, which is the MariaDB partner in China. The customer has some legacy applications using Oracle. The business logic is not complicated, and the workload is quite stable now because so many years. But they still need to pay an expensive Oracle license fee. For these applications. So the customer decided migrating to open source database. MySQL ecosystem is the best choice, but the application is developed by SV and is too old. The source code has been lost, so modify SQL is impossible. The only things we can do is to replace the JDBC driver from Oracle to MySQL or MariaDB. We need the database to be able to run Oracle queries directly. Why this user choose MariaDB finally? First, the customer decided to choose the MariaDB MySQL ecosystem because they consider this is the best open source database ecosystem. Lots of third-party tools, lots of technical documents. Many engineers are familiar with MySQL and commercial support. Then the question is MySQL or MariaDB? Why customer and watch tech consider MariaDB is a better choice? Let's have a look about the Oracle compatibility between MySQL and MariaDB. MySQL doesn't support most of the Oracle syntax and most of the Oracle data types. Migrating from Oracle to MySQL requires lots of changes to MySQL. We consider which is a huge project for years. And MariaDB already support many Oracle syntax and data types, includes some PLSQL, with Oracle SQL mode, and MariaDB already has an Oracle syntax tree. It's easier to add a new Oracle syntax support. So based on MariaDB is the best choice. Then how migrate from Oracle to MariaDB? The first, we should check the connection way, because not all connection methods may modify to connect to MariaDB. The second, collect the queries of applications. The third, analyze the compatibility with MariaDB. The fourth, evaluate workload for modify MariaDB code or application code. Sometimes if you are lucky, the application can modify the queries or change the application code. Then you needn't to modify database source code. The fifth, adding Oracle compatible code in MariaDB. In this case, we are unlucky that the application can't change anything. The sixth, testing the modified MariaDB version in application to verify everything is compatible now. Okay, let's see these steps one by one. The first, check the connection way. If the application is connecting Oracle by JDBC or ODBC, then it's doable. We need only replace the JDBC driver to MariaDB. But if the application is using native COCLab, then we have no way to replace it now. The good news is WatchTech can support Oracle OCI Podcom in Reno proxy product at the end of this year. Okay. The next, collect the queries. It has many ways to do this work, like enable Oracle SQL trace, use $V views, like this wheel $V circle array. If you have a proxy, you can collect all queries in proxy layer. If you are lucky, the application is using the SQL framework like Abatis, then you can get all queries from it. The next, analysis compatibility. SQLize is a good project. Is a good open source project. It can help us to analyze if the queries can revert to another database or not. WatchTech has its own set of tools to analyze whether the queries collected from Oracle can be supported in MySQL or MariaDB. Alibaba Cloud also has a tools named Adam can do this analysis too. And then we need to evaluate workload. MariaDB has done a lot of Oracle compatibility work, like VHR2 and number data type, sequence filter, and many syntax compatibilities like from DLL, Oracle style query procedure, and function. Except the MariaDB already done. For this case, we still have some compatibility work needs to do. For DDL, the Oracle has enable keyword, which is default behavior in MariaDB and can't change. So we can ignore this keyword in query table and index. For DML, the sysstate function in Oracle needn't bracket, but MariaDB require it. We can modify syntax tree to remove it. About three tasks are very easy. Modify syntax tree can solve it. And Oracle has the toolchar function. Can convert the other data type to a string. In MariaDB, most of the time we needn't to convert them manually. MariaDB can automatically complete this work, such as between numbers and string. But for data type, we need to use data format to format it. This task is little more difficult, but we can reuse the MariaDB internal functions, but we still need some changes. The most difficult work is the row number. MariaDB can't support it at all, and we can't find the similar function. Sometimes it looks like a limit, but more complex usage. According analysis and evolution, we know which parts we must modify the code. Then let's do it. For task 1 and 2 and 3, it's easy. Modify server yak file can dump these works. It's quite easy. Just add keywords so that the syntax tree can recognize them. We can see. Okay, we can add the enable keyword after the fulfilled definition, and also we can remove the break site for C state here. So we can see after adding the keywords and alias, MariaDB can run Oracle SQL now. For task 4, we can reuse the date format function to serve it. SQL lines provided the provided a table of mapping the format. Specifiers from Oracle to char function to date format function, modify the make date time in item function file to support the Oracle format specifiers. In the same time, add two char function keyword in circle yak file here. Then we can see MariaDB can support Oracle two-char function now. The most difficult is task number 5, row number. How we implement the row number feature? Our idea is adding row number as a virtual column based on MariaDB virtual column, and then adding a counter named the current row number with the default value is 1. When a row be read, set the row number field value to current row number. When a row sent to client, then current row number plus 1. So if the query hasn't the well case, the current row number is the read sequence number. If the query has a while case without the row number, the row number field will return the sequence number after order by or aggregation. If the query has while case with row number, if the condition is row number greater than 1, it will not return any data. This is the same in Oracle. Once the result set from subquery contains the row number field, we will not add a row number virtual column again, which is the same with Oracle 2. After we have done these changes, we have solved all node incompatibilities. Then we can test the modified MariaDB in user's application. We export and import the table structs and data from user's Oracle database to our modified MariaDB. Then start a test application to connect our MariaDB. And then to verify the application is running well, copy online workload to MariaDB through network traffic copy, and verify the MariaDB can support the online workload. Okay, finally, let's see the progress of this project. This project kick off on July 7, and we got the POC version on September 11. Although this application is not complicated, but the progress is based on MariaDB is so fast and beyond our imagination. Okay, this is all my presentation. Thank you.